In today's video, I'm going to show you how to apply a really cool fisheye lens effect on your footage. And this video is sponsored by Licht. I will tell you more about them later on. For now, let's jump into Premiere Pro. So you see, I have the footage and music in my timeline here. And I want to apply a fisheye effect. First, I'm gonna go over here to the negative space, control click, and first we're going to create a black matte. You can use black video or color matte, it doesn't matter. So I'm gonna press okay and choose the black color, okay. And then we're going to drag and drop this matte on top of the footage and extend it out. The next thing we need to do is go up to effect controls and click on the create ellipse mask. And from here, we can then invert the mask and then you can hover over the edge, press shift and scale it up. And then I will click for the hand tool to make sure that it's centered on either side. And we can go over to the mask feather and increase this up to around 40. So we have a little bit of that feathering around the edges. This is looking pretty good so far. What next? Ah! All right, so now the fun part with the effects. So the mask looks great. Now we're gonna move up the color matte to video layer 3. And from the project panel, I'm going to control click again and create an adjustment layer. And then we're going to drag and drop this adjustment layer onto video layer 2. The first effect that we're going to apply is the spherize effect. So from effects, search for spherize and double click to apply it. From spherize, let's increase the radius, and you're gonna have to increase it a lot till you see the effect happen. We want it to just hit the edges of the mask. Right around here is fine. You can see the center point is here, which is what we want. Next, we're gonna go search for lens distortion, and you're going to use the built-in one underneath distort, double click to apply it, and here we can play around with the curvature. So just click and drag to create some curves. Now we need to scale it up because we don't want the white in the background here. So to do that, rather than going up to motion, since this won't affect the footage beneath because it's an adjustment layer, we actually need to go and apply the transform effect. Double click to apply it to the clip, and then we can scale up the clip using these parameters. Scale it up until it fits perfectly in frame. Now it looks nice and distorted, so we can go back to these other clips here, and you may need to go down to the clip level and realign it into place depending on each clip. So you can go through all the clips and you can realign it until it looks right. Now we can add a Gaussian blur to the edges to give it more of that fisheye look. So select the adjustment layer and go to Gaussian blur and double click to apply it. And here we're going to apply another ellipse mask. And this time we're going to scale it up. So again, hover on the edge, press shift and scale it up. And then we're going to increase the blurriness. But remember, we want it to be inverted. And then from there, we can add some feathering around 60. You can see the before and the after. So it adds just like a slight blur around the edges. So you can play around with how much feathering you want. And the next effect is a plugin, so it is optional, but it's called the BCC PRISM effect, which is part of Boris Effects Continuum. Select the adjustment layer. I'm gonna search for BCC PRISM and double click to apply it. Now this is going to add a little RGB split prism effect. So you can see this is the before and the after. And it just makes it a bit more distorted. That's how you can create this really cool, easy fisheye effect. And so this is how the final effect looks. Yeah. All the crazy shit I did tonight. And one thing to note is that you can apply the effects at the clip level. You don't have to use the adjustment layer, but I find using the adjustment layer to be easier because if you have a strip of clips like I do here, all of the effects will be applied to the clips beneath the adjustment layer. It's just faster. So as you probably heard, I was using David Guetta's song Memories in the background of that fisheye lens montage. So how was I able to use that track without getting demonetized or the video getting taken down? Well, this is where I use Licht. So what you can do is you can sign up for a Licht plan, connect your YouTube channel, and be able to purchase licenses to these popular mainstream tracks that you love. In addition to the mainstream tracks, which you pay per license per track, you can also access for a monthly fee unlimited stock music. So if you want to be able to find some cool background tracks that maybe aren't the chart mainstream music, they have that option as well. So if you want to get a discount on your first track, you can use my link below. You can also get 14 days free of their stock music to use in your YouTube videos. What's also cool, when you're browsing the library, you can sort by what's popular on Spotify or what's popular on YouTube. So you can see what types of tracks are currently trending, and then you can search by mood, theme, genre, length, tempo, and you can also filter by target platform. So if you don't want to use it on YouTube, but you want to use it on Facebook or Instagram, for example, you can filter by what can be used on Instagram and go from there. Another useful tip is sometimes I want to use popular mainstream music, but the instrumental versions. So you can go up here and select instrumental, and from here you can go over and you can search the popular songs that you can use that are instrumental, mainstream, and that can be used on Instagram, for example. If you have any questions about Lick, be sure to leave a comment below, and you can also click right here to go check it out and sign up for your own plan. And if you want to learn some more music video effects or cool effects in Premiere Pro, you can click right over here. That's all for today's video. Thanks so much for watching, and as always, keep creating better video with a gal. See you next time. Bye.